Taxpayers will shell out $3.4 billion for the Morrison government's decision to tear up Australia's submarine deal with France. Newly elected Prime Minister Anthony Albanese today revealed he's reached a final compensation deal with the French contractor. He's described the whole saga as an extraordinary waste of money.
It blew a multi-billion dollar defence deal out of the water and torpedoed our relationship with a Pacific power.
Do you think he lied to you?
I don't think, I know.
But now the new Prime Minister says he's drawing a line under the cancelled French submarine contract.
Now we can move forward with our relationship with France.
A relationship that is critical at a time when China's military build-up is unprecedented.
Australia's investments in defence capability are a necessary and prudent response to the military build-up we see taking place in the Indo-Pacific.
At a regional security summit, China today questioned the new defence minister over our security pact with the US and UK, known as AUKUS.
Do you think in the Asia-Pacific region, AUKUS is the best security cooperation model in this region? Is this a mini NATO?
AUKUS is not a mini NATO.
The failed French deal will mean a final $830 million payment to shipbuilder Naval Group, bringing the total cost to $3.4 billion. Around $1 billion less than predicted, but still with no subs to show for it.
It still represents an extraordinary waste from a government that was always big on announcement but not good on delivery.
But there is another issue. The nuclear subs under the AUKUS deal won't be ready until around 2040. Australia's six Collins-class subs are ageing and due to be withdrawn from service in 2036, leaving us exposed.
It really is critical in terms of probably accepting an interim submarine capability, but doing so alongside investment in other areas.
Those options aren't cheap, including a multi-million dollar long-range stealth bomber or an underwater autonomous submarine similar to this. The now opposition leader Peter Dutton has also hinted he believes we could secure two ready-built American subs by 2030.
Didn't say anything when he was defence minister, did he?
Our Collins-class submarines are still regionally superior, but as Mr. Dutton has made clear, by 2035, it's going to be a far more contested and competitive environment.
As far as repairing our relationship with France goes, the PM says he's now been invited to Paris to meet with President Macron. The visit is expected to take place later this year.
The tensions between Australia and France, I think, have been pretty obvious, and they go from the top. I intend to have an honest relationship.
In an increasingly aggressive Pacific, it is a vital partnership. Ursula Hager for 10 News First.